And it's a wave clear hero. I don't really like Puck against Tiny and Doom, and then you also got the Grimstroke to worry about. There's just too many annoying heroes for Puck. Tiny especially can just go in, toss you, burst you, and you're gonna either be with 10% HP or dead. So it's very bad hero, I think, overall in this game. And then Execration go with the Juggernaut. So the Juggernaut, Grimstroke, solid lane. Then you got the Grimstroke Inkswell on the Juggernaut. He can go in. Terrorblade, probably gonna get Omni slashed up with like a Mjolnir jug or something that can kill a Terrorblade, especially if his BKB is on cooldown. Most likely, Terrorblade might not even buy BKB because he's playing against Doom. So we'll see. We've definitely seen a lot of like SNY or Manta, Satanic, Scotty Terrorblades against Doombringers just because of that reason. But in this game, he might have to go BKB anyway because the Tiny and the Grim. There is a Magnus. No, there's not a Magnus. That's a lie, boys. Execration first phase bad Magnus. There's no Magnus.
No Magnus, yeah, and again, you know, this region, they just don't seem to care about the Venomancer. He's just getting through every time. Venomancer gets all the way through the draft, no one picking him up. It's pretty crazy.
Hold on, I'm going to cut you off for a moment. So, yeah, is it me that's getting the robotics? Because, like, it's like, it was fine.
Oh,
and then
no, Discord the whole time?
Was it Discord, isn't it? Should we hang? Let's recall.
Let's recall, okay, all right.
5 seconds remaining.
Hopefully that has how am I? Am I Robo Nomad?
Oh, that's so much better.
Okay. You got the milky
that's
sounds.
Awesome.
Cool. All right, cool. Let's get back into this draft. So it seems like Execration. I mean, well, there's no real team fight coming out for either team right now, which does surprise. I mean, I guess there's Puck and Jakira kind of combo.
I think there's a lot of
that,
team
but...
fight. You got the Grim Doom combo. That's pretty big.
True. I guess it makes
then you
sense.
Got the Puck Earth Spirit combo too. Quite a good amount of team fight. It's not like some epic, you know, long cooldown team fight. I guess Doom kind of is that, but it's still a lot of team fight. I think what these teams are aiming for is having good team fight, but while having really strong laning heroes as well.
Yeah, a lot of faith being put in their carries here. I mean, who do you prefer? Like, what does this carry matchup look like to you with the Juggernaut and the Terrorblade?
So I actually prefer Terrorblade a little bit more. But the thing is, this is Terrorblade into Doom, Grim, Sand King. Like, Sand King is freaking insanely good against TB as well.
Yeah, that's a lot of magic damage. It's AoE magic damage as well. It can kind of throw down onto the TB and can control him up. And obviously, TB, you know, he relies on his armor a lot. So yeah, I like the Sand King pick a hell of a lot. How does it do in lane? Does it do well against him in lane as well?
Yeah, it does. It's amazing in lane. Sand King is only bad against, like, Anti-Mage, maybe Juggernaut. That's it. Everything else, like, Sand King does very, very good in lane against.
Yeah.
What I mean by good is, like, he's going to have a solid fight. Like, he's going to be very strong.
Final pickup is going to be the Monkey King for Blaze. Interesting. This is not a popular hero right now, but Blaze is going to go for it regardless. Okay, well, you know what? I'm assuming this is a laning thing. I guess they now see that the Doom's going to be middle, and they just want to lay the smackdown on Tim. So they're going to pick the Monkey King, melee versus melee.
It's pretty good, but I think this Monkey, if he dies like once or twice, he just falls off really hard. And things that get really, really bad for him. There's so many stuns he has to play against. Sand King, Tiny, Inkswell. The Doom is going to doom him on level 6 with the rotation from the Tiny and the Grimstroke, and then his late game is going to be non-existent. So I'm kind of worried. I don't like this Monkey pick that much either. I don't like the Puck pick. I really don't like the Monkey pick either. 5 seconds. They have to do a lot.
It's the same theory as well, isn't it? You know, with the armor, when he pops up Wukong's, he's going to be feeling like a god. Sand King's going to swoop in from the side. Tiny's going to combo him. He's still going to die inside his Wukong's. Like, he needs a BKB so badly this game. And yep, I don't like it when teams play around, like, a space creator who needs a BKB to be effective. Because you're basically saying, well, this guy's going to create space when he's got a BKB, and that's not really what you want to be hearing. So, yeah, I have a few problems with this. I'm hoping that Blaze are going to be able to play at this tempo, and they're going to win their lanes hard enough to make this Monkey King pickup work for them. But I also think this Puck needs to have a good game in the offlane as well, and I don't know if that's going to happen.
Hmm.
It's going to be the
Puck. I would have to agree with that.
The Earth Spirit.
The worst thing that can happen for Blaze is Monkey and the Puck both get Grim Altered and doomed up. And then the TB's like, well, I guess I'll just run now. He can't even stand his ground and fight. Because he will be dead if it's the last one left, right? There's so many disables on the side of X-Ray.
Yeah, yeah. I feel like X-Creation have a pretty straightforward game ahead of them, honestly. And yeah, I mean, we need to see some really convincing lanes coming out from Blaze, then leading into a game where they can just put so much pressure whilst the Monkey King still farms. You know, the Monkey King can't fall behind too far this game, I feel. I think that's basically what's on the cards right now for both these teams. So let's get into it. Game number one, Execration versus Blaze, now starting up here in the Mega League Asia Division play-ins. A play-in is, of course, when the two teams who've come fourth and fifth have to battle against each other to play into the playoffs.
Dude, I love play-ins. This is their last chance. I'm not going to lie. I freaking love play-ins, man. It's like you give another chance for that one team who's like on the borderline, right? And then it's like the other team has to earn it. What I do like, though, in play-ins is when... let's say you're the team that's the higher seed in the play-in, then you have to win like you have to win one game to get in, and the team that's coming in from the lower seed has to win two games to get in. So they have to earn it, right? Because they did get a lower seed getting into the play-in.
Yeah, make the fifth and fifth player against each other, and then make the
It's like a winner. It's like a winner advantage kind of situation. I really like. Like game things like that, because it makes things so much more interesting, right?
It does indeed, and it gives a team a chance to really prove themselves as well and prove that they're ready to make those playoffs and maybe put in a performance and take some games with those bigger teams right now. Meanwhile, Palos being jumped in the bottom lane, being chased by this Earth Spirit in this park, just a bit of harass, a bit of tickling going on, nothing too severe here. Well, BDZ's coming on over. I mean, they could go for the Inkswell toss onto the puck if they wanted to, but he has got an orb, so that would be a bad idea. Two very high mobility heroes. Very tricky to get any blood onto. And they're just going to relax, chill out, get themselves some bounty runes here, but I've got to go even on that as well. Nothing particularly exciting happening at this minute zero. We already mentioned about top lane and mid lane briefly. We talked about it. We think, at least I thought that this top lane is going to be actually pretty safe for the TB. I mean, TB Jakiro is actually a pretty decent lane, and you're laning into what's going to be a Sand King and a Tiny. Which I don't... It's okay if you get kills, but I'm not sure that's going to happen. These guys are just going to get kited by Jakiro.
So this lane is literally all about getting healing solves on the Sand King. Mm-hmm. Right now he's getting chased down by TB. You should have been not surprised by that. Oh, the Raging Guard. Yeah, so... You just get healing solves, you pop those up, you get like level 2 sandstone, then on level 4, you get that Bro Strike, you get the Caustic Finale, and Tiny, hopefully it's like level 3 by then, this TB is gonna die every time. He has to be very, very careful at that point. But until then, the TB is definitely gonna have a very good lane. Oh my god, they're denying everything.
Yeah, this is beautiful. This is beautiful.
Yeah, I mean, double melee heroes versus TB is not a very good idea here.
Nope, certainly not. And Jakiro as well. I mean, he loves playing. When you're playing like Jakiro, Dazzle, Witch Doctor to a lesser extent, but any hero, nice range creep at least from the Tiny there, with these kind of slowing mechanics and decent right click, then you feel miserable in the double melee lane. Like, this support can just own you, and that's exactly what Kaz is doing here.
You know what I like? If they went the Grim and the Sand King top, oh man, Terrorblade would be freaking scared for his life. Every time he gets stroked up,
yeah, Terrorblade doesn't like being stroked. He's not a dog.
They're stroked, yeah.
Well, Jakiro, some people like a bit of damage. They have a toss, and are actually going to toss in the Sand King. Can they finish the job? Doesn't look like it. Caustic's probably not going to be enough to finish the job quite this early on, so Kaz will live to see another day. But yeah, just showing that they can get this nuke potential up in this top lane. Meanwhile, over towards middle lane, XHD picking into the Doom to try and counter him out here. And, you know, so far, not so good. 7-4 to the 9-2, doing all right on the Doom here. And I would expect this Monkey King, you know, now he's got his 2 points in Jingu, he can really start to put down the pressure because, I mean, Doom's kind of just got to accept the fact that he's going to get Jingu'd up. And now that Scorched Earth is gone, I imagine XHD starts to pull ahead a little bit.
Just a little bit. But at some point, I think this Doom just gotta go into the jungle and then wait for a rotation from his team when they go for the power runes.
Yeah, it's a pretty, it's just pretty beefy lane, these two dudes. I think it's hard to actually kill the Doom, but all Monkey King really wants to do is get off the Jingu and then dominate the CS. You know, it's not about killing this Doom. Right. It's not about getting the Boundless Strike and finishing him off. Contrary to popular belief, you don't need to kill the enemy mid laner three times in order to be considered winning the lane. It's just about the... oh, is he blocking? He's blocking the medium camp. Look at that. Yeah, that's so nice. I mean, this means that Devour's about to come off cooldown, and he doesn't have a way to get rid of it. He's you know, he's going to have to go and use it on a small creep, which is just...
He should go to their medium camp, or the other medium camp that's, like, a little bit lower. Yeah, he's going to go to their medium camp.
Smart boy, Ken. See, this is why they pay him the big bucks.
You have to get the medium... You have to get the creep no matter what. There's, like, no other option. The medium camp creep.
Mm-hmm.
There's only, like, what, one small creep that's good? The... Ghost creep, and it's actually there.
Yeah, you could have got the ghosty boy. You mean the heal creep's no good?
It's only good for mana. Yourself. It's only good for mana.
Oh, right, the cost effectiveness, yeah.
Right, the cost is like has a cast animation. It's really hard to use. Yeah. I was actually playing a position 4 Doom where I did that, and I went to my offlaner and I kept healing him, and the enemy mid got so... I mean, enemy carry got so mad. He just all chatting the entire time.
Oh, Sand King up at the top lane. Raging Potato is actually going to go down to the second Metamorphosis. Jesus, Raging Potato. Holding for first blood.
Tiny also went back to base too. But this is where it gets a bit scary, because now the TB is not going to have meta anymore. The Sand King is going to get top. He's going to get level 4. And then he's got to be a bit afraid of this lane.
Does he even need to stay here, though? Tiny.
Yeah, he will stay until he's at least level 5.
You reckon? Okay.
He wants that... He wants that level 3 conjure image before he leaves it. But you can see how much damage he actually takes from the magic.
Yeah, he can't mess around. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, though, Monkey King actually getting the kill, but in comes BDZ trying to get the return, but he doesn't have any damage left, and he's actually just chasing this Monkey under tower. Not sure that's the best idea, and he will realize that himself and back himself away. But yeah, I mean, that's just XHD getting the kill off onto the Doom. Pretty big deal in the mid lane, I would say. Also, I don't know if he... I think he actually luckily died without Devour. Meanwhile, all the Air Spirit dying in the bottom lane. He's going to get killed off by the Juggernaut with that spin. Easy peasy kill there for Execration. Yeah, there's something about Doom as well. If you die with the Devour buff, this Devour buff on you, then don't you, like, not get the gold at the end?
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty there painful. But that didn't happen last time.
Doom is getting gone on again.
Yeah, he is going to be able to dodge out this roll, luckily enough. XHD still trying to chase, but that's just not happening anymore with that roll not connecting. Yeah. The Doom's able to run himself away, and the movement speed from Scorched Earth makes it pretty easy to dodge him.
There we go. There we go.
See what they can do. They're looking for the dragon, and they're going to toss him back in towards Raging Potato here, as he's got that Spirit Strike coming out as well with the Avalanche. They have the damage to bring down Kaz, isolating this TB and leaving him alone. But to be honest, he's got a wave pushing in close to his tower. Like, he's not feeling too bothered about this, to be honest, so... You know, once the support is dead, there's no pressure coming out on Timmy. He just continues to hit these creeps. Now level 5 as well, so can ditch this lane whenever he feels like it. But he's got one more Metamorphosis ready to go in 5 seconds, so it may well be wanting to make something happen with this.
He wants to remove the catapult before he leaves the lane. He doesn't want to let that catapult go into the tower and kill it.
Good old safe health. Such a wholesome name. Level. No. Yeah, you don't want to stand in that, that's for sure. I'll give you, I'll sting your eyes. I'll say that much.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, in the middle lane, this time it's a Monkey King who goes down, but the Air Spirit will also be eating the ground as Ken comes in. Yeah, they doom up the Monkey King, and that is enough to grab them that kill. Took a long time,
this is
actually.
Pretty big. The mid catapult is also still alive, so they're going to do a lot of damage onto this tower. The Monkey is going to want to TP back in here, but it's a little bit scary if the Tiny actually sticks around. Tiny's actually running away. He's going somewhere else right now. He's going to ward deep in the jungle.
Alright, they're going to leave it. With this. Yeah, I mean, there's no way Blaze is going to let their mid tower fall, is there? So Ken actually able to just sidestep the ice path again as this two support rotation results in really absolutely nothing. Very, very painful here. I need to focus up. I need to start catching these kills, man. It's first, you know, first series, first game of the day. Need to sharpen up on the old observer skills.
Are you telling me you didn't watch another game before this, Nomad?
I didn't do any practice observing, no.
Unacceptable, sire.
Did some practice casting, of course. You know, a bit of got some highlight videos I like to watch, and then give a bit of ad lib over the top.
What's your favorite highlight videos to watch?
Weirdly, eons ago, I used to do some highlight videos for Noob from UA. When there was all that stuff about not using it. And he sent me like loads of these highlight videos, which just had no, like, had the game sounds but no commentary over the top. So those are absolutely perfect. So I've got like a backlog of like games from. So I think one of them is it TNC versus one of the NA teams. Maybe Quincy. Okay. No, Chaos. That's it. TNC versus Chaos. Yeah, that's the one I use the most. Just because. So at some point, maybe I think it's start of like September, last September.
Okay.
I think so. Yeah. So that's the one I usually use, just because it's like the last one he sent me. Yeah. And there you go. That's how I want for a cast, everybody. Any aspiring casters, and. Maybe do the same thing, find yourself a little highlight, or make your own highlight reel, and then just have something to cast from before a game.
Discord is really shitting the bed today. My goodness.
It's tanking it, is it? It's fine on my end. Like, you sound peachy.
Yeah, I can't. I literally can't hear you half the time because of it.
you need to reconnect, or maybe change service?
I'm gonna restart my Discord.
Okay, alright, sounds like a plan. Hard to say who that could be, but we're gonna lose Steven for a minute, lose his precious analysis, and now you guys are left with Potato Brain Nomad to guide you through this game. But don't worry, we'll focus on the action. And there might be some action coming up here. There is a double damage rune up at top, but no, BDZ is just gonna take it. None of the mid laners going in for this one. I'm not even sure they have bottles, do they? They're just kind of. No, look at this guy. Oh my god, the dude's going for a Midas. That's so greedy. Midas, Doom, Drums, Jug. Okay.
He went for Midas, yeah. I think it's way better if he actually goes for Phase Woods first before the Midas, so you got that armor, that movement speed going. Because, like, going Midas straight is, like you said, so, so greedy. It's so, so greedy. I hate it when people do this, when they just go first item Midas on a hero like Doom, who needs to be able to run in and stuff. Like, you want to secure your game before you buy the Midas. Like, that's how that item actually works. You know, unless you're super far behind, but it's only 8 minutes in, he's not even super far behind, right? If he buys a face boost now, he's got Doom, he's got stun, like if any rotations mid, this monkey is actually the one who fears this Doom, you know?
Yeah.
But if he buys a Midas, then he's gonna miss all these opportunities to be able to kill and play aggressive.
Yeah. At the same time, though, I do feel like this Monkey King has kind of failed in his mission to put pressure on the Doom and kind of win this mid lane. He hasn't done that.
I don't think he can, though. It's really hard. No. Like, you actually cannot do it properly because, one, he has Max Devour. This is a super greedy Doom who has Max Devour. Two, you got that Doom, so the rotation from Tiny and Grim, these are powerful support heroes who go mid, just made it so annoying for him to actually play the game anymore. Like, every time they're off the map, he's so scared that they're smoking on him, they want to Doom him again. That one Doom kill just did too much already, and at this point, like, he's just any other hero. Yeah, he's just a Monkey King now. He's just not, like, anything special.
Poor Monkey King, but he is a pretty poopy hero currently. Meanwhile, RR getting a couple of spells thrown on him, but BDZ jumping on in here, looking for the Earth Spirit, but gets silenced up, so can't finish the combo. And Earth Spirit's going to be able to just waddle himself away. Four heroes in the bottom lane for the side of the Dire. Meanwhile, four arriving for the Radiant here as they battle over these bounties, and it is going to be the Earth Spirit who picks it up. Meanwhile, Coil comes down onto two over here. Grimstroke taking a lot of damage. He's going to draw. Meanwhile, the Doom not looking that healthy either. Trying to turn it around, but he's silenced up. Doesn't get up. The Doom just dies to the Metamorphosis TB, dashing out so much damage here, safe health. And now a beautiful Ice Path going to catch out the Tiny as well. Early levels, but XHD, he's got the damage. He's looking for more as well. Palos on the run, and I think he might be getting out of this one, but XHD, he's still chasing, he still wants it, but he's got the spin on the Juggernaut to get himself away with, and there will be no death for Palos here in mid.
The classic Nomad, the classic TP to the safe lane, defend the tower, give up more than you would have if you just let the tower go. Oh, Sanking is going
nice
in.
Jump, though.
So.
Yeah,
Sanking.
He's got a really nice catch. Oh, it's airplane. Run. Dude, he's dead. They've got the Scorched Earth.
Okay. Oh my goodness. I was gonna say, if he actually lived, that Earth Spirit was MVP there, because he, I think, silenced and stunned up the Grimstroke, so he couldn't cast any other spells there. But yeah, the Doom coming in with the Scorched Earth. I mean, they managed to defend it, but it was pretty costly, though. They TP'd so many heroes bottom, they lost three heroes themselves, too. Yep. They do have the Doom still. That's the one good redeeming thing. And Juggernaut has made his way to the top jungle area. He's going for the Battle Fury build. I think this game is fine, I guess. They have so much magic damage on Radiant anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I still prefer the Maelstrom personally, just because you're playing against these two really high armor heroes. Like, if you Omni Slash the Monkey King inside of his Wukongs with a bit of extra damage,
attack speed also
kill, but
helps your Omni Slash way more, too.
Yeah, yeah, that as well. Yeah. That as well. But never mind, never mind. We'll go down the Battle Fury route again. And yeah, they've got Grimstroke 6, by the way, so possibility of double Doom at mid if Blaze aren't careful.
Blaze are going to smoke down to bottom. They really want to get this bottom tower, open up the map in some way. Actually, they're going to go into Doom. He's out of position.
Yeah, the Boundless Strike with the Jingu already waiting from before. A lot of damage coming down onto Jen. They're going to have to throw down tries to go for the ultimate, but actually fluffs it. And now the Tiny, he's going to get bought down as well, it looks like. Although the Dolph, Jesus, what happened? Now they go over towards the Jakiro. Double toss with the Omni Slash takes him down super quickly as Kaz is now getting run down. There's a spin, there's the damage. See you later, Kaz. And now there's going to be three more heroes dead on the side of Blaze.
Oh, that was nice in the end. I mean, the Doom still didn't use Doom, so it's actually super good for Execration. And that double toss from the Grimstroke Soulbind held them together for a while, so the Juggernaut can TP in an Omni Slash. Nice. And they're gonna get the mid tower too. That's huge, dude. That's a nice sword from Jug, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, it certainly is. He had a lot of fun in that last fight. And Raging, I mean, they've just got so many fighting spells up on the side of Execration with this Doom, with this Epicenter. And this is a great Epicenter game, as we mentioned before. You know, Raging Potato could do so much work on this Sand King.
Yeah. Raging Potato has been so focused on just getting these lanes out. And because of that, he's been building up a lot of net worth, too. He knows, like, this guy, he played at TI, you know, he got top 8, I think. Top 8? Or they got, like, just barely top 8. But I think they got, like, 9th place or something.
Oh, with Mineski?
You know, he knows the importance of, like, not joining bad fight, right? Very calculated player, very seasoned player. And you can see, like, how his team is constantly fighting, but he's like, I know my job, guys. I don't need to be there. Let me just push the lanes out. Blaze can't do anything as long as these lanes are pushed out. So he's just going to continue doing that. He's already got a dagger. He's on his way to Yules already. This is one of the most farm snankings you're going to see.
This Jug just flexing in the bottom lane, saying, you've got no spin cancel. I'm just going to kill your crit wave out from under your noses. And does exactly that. I mean, this is a high commitment to the bottom tier 1 tower. They will finally get it down here, but, you know, this is meta. This is a 5-hero rotation down to bottom. Let's see what happens here. As BDZ is going to get a smoke pop. They see the Earth Spirit, but they're going to go on the Monkey King to start off this fight. Do they have the damage to bring him down? The Inkswell is pretty damn good, and now just the Juggernaut slashing away at him. XXG is going to lose his life, and Blaze need to get themselves out, but that might be a luxury the Sand King has, as Earth Spirit has, as he gets cut off by the Juggernaut. Paulus gets himself the double. Meanwhile, on the sidelines, even if Parkers get caught out here and they've got the toss, he's not going to be able to get back to his orb. Oh, he just about does it. That was close, but Sand King's still waiting in the wings. He's got himself that Burrow Strike, but the Blink Dagger still on cooldown for another 3 seconds, and Beyond will survive. Well, goodness me, that is sloppy from Blaze here. His Execration are really starting to kind of gain momentum in this game.
It was a nice rotation from Execration too. They wanted to go into the triangle area and plant some vision, then they just surprisingly found them with the smoke. Oh,
Puck going in
over
here, dropping the coil down onto the Tiny, and yeah, they throw down the Doom onto somebody. Oh, the Puck in the backlines. Meanwhile, BDZ is going to lose his life to the Monkey King. They're trying to slice through the two of them here. They've got them held together, and with that Inkswell spin as well, too much damage coming down from the Jug. They are going to be able to get those couple of kills, and once again, I mean, Blaze just making these awful, awful trades. Losing a lot. I don't know, man. It felt like a really weird time to fight. You know, the TP wasn't ready for it. The Monkey King was there, but he's just not really a hero right now. All he's got is phased drums, you know?
They 100% messed up in this draft. Like, the Puck pick itself was pretty bad, and then the Monkey pick was just so optimistic in whatever they were planning to do. Like, this is why nobody gives Doom away to any teams. You have to have a way better idea than, oh, I'm gonna pick Monkey, he's gonna go 1v1 against Doom, and then we're gonna win. No, it's so bad, like, you can't. This Doom just pops a Doom on your Monkey, he dies one time, whatever advantage he got is gone, instantly. So, you can see this is like a perfect example of this game, and on top of that, they have a TB, right? And TB needs a lot of space. He wants to just farm, he wants his four heroes to just play together and not feed, if possible. But they're actually feeding, so Execration are taking full advantage of this game, and every Doom has been very clutch. He's got a blink now too on the Doombringer. This is getting so scary. Sanking's got insane amount of levels as well. Tiny's already got that max out Avalanche and Toss. Like, I think Execration just hit their power spike. Like, just now. But even before that, they've already been owning.
Yeah, when the 6k gold ahead, now they hit their power spike. And Blaze, they have to be scared. They have to be very, very scared. This poor Terrorblade, I mean, he's done nothing wrong this game, but at the same time, his team had just made the wrong movements, and he doesn't seem like he's going to get much of a chance to play this one. But still, a lot of Dota to go, a lot to be had yep. still on the map, so there's plenty of mistakes still to be made from Execration as well.
You can't underestimate the Terrorblade, even if he's the only one that has high net worth. If Execution make one bad move, jump the wrong target, or miss a skill, and the TB just gets to pound on them, we can definitely see the fights turn in the favor of Blaze. Blaze is just having a really hard time pushing lanes out, though, because of this tiny sanking catch potential. Then there's also the Doom with the blink now, too. Mid tower, they're getting surrounded. Oh, this tower's being surrounded is very, very good for Blaze. If they can get a ward behind the tier 1, that would be nice. But if they don't, then it could be a little bit more difficult to attack Execration.
Yeah, they've got the Monkey King here, but he doesn't... They are indeed giving it up, yeah.
Yeah, they meta'd up. They know they can't go into this without any vision of their own, right, on Execration side. Very disciplined play from them not to actually commit to this.
Yeah, and Rage of Dead is just going to plonk himself down inside that sandstorm, be as annoying as possible, and try and push out this wave.
Mm-hmm. One of the things about Chinese teams, too, is, like, this is their zone. This is their, like, field, you know? When they're behind, they got to farm up one of their carries. They're really good at, like, just trying to not give away too many kills.
Spirit, although the toss combo is a little bit off the mark, he accidentally tossed the Sand King instead. Now Earth Spirit just going for the TP away and will just
Base.
About make it. Whew.
Base.
Base indeed, yeah. Jumps wasted, the spells used. Yeah, and this middle tower's down as well, so not feeling too bad on Blaze right now. They're buying themselves a little bit of breathing room here. This Juggernaut is getting larger and larger as time goes on, heading towards that Manta at rather an alarming rate, but nevertheless, Terrorblade still almost matching him on farm for farm. And the Doom's farming up very quickly as well, but he does have a Midas, so that is 2,000 gold of his, which is essentially put towards something which isn't that useful, so... it says the numbers say 9,500. I'd probably say about 8,000-ish is his real net worth, but... He's still a Doom. He's still got that big fat spell to throw down on people, so.
Mm-hmm.
Looking for the
BKB. They're actually gonna break into their own jungle here. Oh, this is a very risky move from Blaze. Are they gonna let this Jakiro get away with this? No, they're going for the big targets. There
they
we go.
Are indeed jumping the back lines. TB and Puck both locked down. They don't even see a stand a chance here as they get ripped in twain. XHD trying to fight up into these guys. I mean, he can get off the Jingu, but now what? I mean, Reggie Potato is actually gonna go down here. Juggernaut trying to fight into XHD. They do have the damage, they do have the Warsaw, they do have the lockdown, and now the Wukong is down, his armor is gone with it, and they can get themselves an ultra kill on Paulos. What an absolute smackdown. I mean, that fight was over before it began, man. They jump at the back line to get the two of them together, the Puck and the Terrorblade. No more of a perfect initiation could be possible from Execration.
They just went into the vision of Execration. Execration's like, oh, we see two guys right there because of our ward. Let's just jump on them. You know, the back line, the dangling Jakiro was not the target they went on, which was perfect because he was the bait.
Indeed, indeed.
Very, very nice. I mean, this is where, like I said, Tiny with Blink, like, he's power spiking real hard right now. He's gonna run around, combo anybody he sees. He also got that Mango Tree, he's got plenty of mana. Oh, Ripper Spirit.
He tried to go for the bounty, didn't get the bounty, met his fate instead. See you later, dot, dot.
So Juggernaut has a Manta now. This is an extremely farmed Juggernaut. He's going for Ags next. I wouldn't mind seeing, like, a Monkey King bar. I think that's a pretty good item for him, too. So, like, preemptively buying that. But, I mean, Ags is still good too. So you can get closer to your opponent, make them think it's an Omni Slash.
Yeah, well, the thing with this game as well is that it's not even a preemptive Monkey King bar. It's the TB's got the talent, right? At level 10, 16% evasion. So, but yeah, he is going for the Ags.
It's also
quick
for
slash. Yeah. I mean, to me, the most broken thing about Quick Slash is that it's really hard to tell if it's Omni Slash or Quick Slash.
Oh, yeah.
Like, part of it is
you
just
can't
mental.
You can't give the information for your team, right? It's really, really difficult. But the best part about it, too, is that you just get on top of it after the quick slash.
Yeah, Yeah.
The hero. And it does a lot of damage too. It's like 3 attacks, right?
Yeah, it's insane. It's insane. You're immortal for those 3 attacks as well. Like, can't take any damage, can't be touched, can't be used spells a lot. I mean, it's pretty mental. The very similar to the Sven Aghs, just a little less crazy than the Sven Aghs, I would say.
It's good when you're ahead, not amazing when you're behind though. I mean,
true.
Like
true.
That's just Juggernaut. When this hero is like super far ahead, he just seems like this amazing, absolutely monstrosity of a hero. But then when he plays from behind, he feels like absolute dog. Right?
Yeah,
it's not like a Terrorblade or a Phantom Assassin or an Anti-Mage where you're a little bit behind, but you know you can come back into the game.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of think that's how the hero just. How it is designed though, because he is one of a really strong laning carry. Like he's got the blade fury, he's got the healing ward, he's got the like every single one of his spells is really nice early on, unlike most carry heroes. So he has a lot of potential to win his lanes, and I think that's how the hero is meant to work. You know, you're supposed to do well and come in from ahead, because once you fall behind as Jug, you do feel very impotent. Oh, look at the illusion chasing down that healing ward. Yeah, get him.
Oh yeah, and Healing Ward is one of the most obnoxious spells in the game too. Especially if you don't have any range heroes who can just go in and get that. Oh,
we want fight down at bottom. Yeah, gets himself for a turn kill. Does die himself though, so I mean this should mean the defense is possible, but they're going in deep here. Look at this Doom coming down onto the TB. TB trying to run himself away. XHD coming in as well. Yeah, not sure about this one, Chief. BKB being popped, they actually find the Esper on the sidelines here. Ken losing health here, but trying to defend this one as Kaz buys back, goes for the ice path, misses onto everybody. They're all getting out, or are they XHD coming in and they get the roll forward onto the tiny mic? Might lose his life. Meanwhile, Ken gets taken down by the puck in the backlands. Beyond does find him. Meanwhile, they will take down the Tiny. They get one return kill onto the Air Spirit, but that is a bad offensive from Execration.
And what you're doing. That was like one of the most aggressive Doom into the tier 4s. Like, I get it. You want to pop that guy right away, but your team was not on the same page. You got to let your team know what you're going to do before you actually do it. Because if that Tiny was nearby, sure, that would have been amazing, right? They would have got the TV, and they would have been like, yeah, good job, Ken. But then the communication just wasn't there. They got to get more disciplined, man.
Yeah, I mean, this was like, this felt a lot like the Magnus RP from, I can't remember who did it.
That was a pretty big overextension. Yeah, I remember that. Yesterday.
Yeah, very much on the same vibes as that guy, you know, just these mid laners getting a bit ahead of themselves, diving in a little bit too deep. You know, the Doom under the tier 4s at 20 minutes, generally speaking, not the play. But, you know, maybe if you had the follow-up, it would have been better. Nevertheless, they'll learn from that one and move on with life. Especially when you got the Grimstroke man as well. Like, they got Blink Grimstroke. It is not going to be hard for them to get off these double dooms in these fights. So,
He wants to get that perfect positioning for so he can blink in and get the perfect 2 targets, right?
Yeah, 100%. If Soulbind is a value spell, then I love seeing Blink on Grimstroke.
Yeah. Tanking has Vessel and Yules. Very good items. What else? Tiny go for this game. Bale. Okay. Oh, Smoke Up. Here we go, Sanking.
See you later, buddy. That is roasted crab for dinner. Or
crab.
Side of Blaze.
Isn't he a scorpion?
Alright, scorpion, fine. You don't generally eat scorpions, though. I'm sure some
people
do. Okay, alright.
Dude, I saw so many scorpions when I was in Beijing. In the market, night market.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah,
did you try one?
No.
What am I?
I'm so scared to try those. Oh, here we go.
Meanwhile, Palos, getting jumped right now, but does get off the actual full Omni Slash here. This is a farming Omni Slash if ever I've seen one. Now the Quick Slash come down as well. They'll take down the Pug. They'll take down the Earth Spirit. So much damage coming out, but now the Jug's in trouble. They're going to take him down with the TP, with the meta and the BKB, and now they drop the Wukongs. They really want to take him down for a second time here, and it looks like they're going to do is go for the TP. Do they have the damage? Oh, they do. Just about on the knife's edge. The Juggernaut does go down. Another big loss for Execration, and Blaze actually coming back into this one. Earth Spirit, he's up on the cliff right now. It's actually doing him quite a lot of work as he dodges out the combo from BDZ, which could have caused him a bit of bother. And everyone else coming on in here. Kaz is ready with the Ice Pop. They're going to lock down, but look at Raging Potato coming in from the sidelines here with the Doom coming down as well onto the Monkey King. Monkey King, though, still trying to highlight his ground, trying to fight up into this one. He's got the BKB, so he's not taking too much damage. Jingu's going to come off as well, and he can try and heal up through the Doom. Takedown two. Oh my goodness. God. Another wasted Doom, another failed team fight, and another step back into this game for Blaze.
RR2, RR is so... Wait, what? Well, RR's actually turning on him. Okay.
Who's going on whom? Nice job, dude. That Grimstroke knows his limits. And now Ken popping that BKB, turning around onto the Jakiro. This isn't over yet as they jump forward to get themselves a second. Ken gets a double kill, says, I don't need Doom to be a hero. I've got myself a ton of money, and I've got myself my best friend Grimstroke. Buddies forever.
Dude, R is like carrying that so hard. Holy shit. Oh, yeah. He knows where to be. He knows that was a bad fight. He knows that guy was all by himself. Like, Puck wasn't there.
The old chat Jakiro dash. Wasn't there.
Okay. Look at his score. He's 0-1-21. Position 5 right here. This man is in the zone.
What the hell?
He's the only one on this team who's like, guys, this is how we win the game, okay?
Yeah.
Just stop. Stop doing your nonsense already. We're like so far ahead. Yeah. This is the problem with like Execration, you know, Neon, these guys. Sometimes they're just too wild, you know? You gotta like tame these beasts. They're really good though. They have amazing spellcasting abilities. You know, they know how to perfectly time everything, but they're a little bit chaotic. And sometimes that's why they throw the game. Someone's gotta push the brakes on this team. And RR is that guy on this team right now.
Yeah, he seems to know the pace. He seems to know what they need to be doing and when they need to be doing it. That's exactly the mark of a good four player. A good player you want on your team. Or a good five player.
A good captain.
Yeah, absolutely. But it's Blaze who...
And I know these things because I was on the Filipino team. I know what it was like.
You still... Do the screams of go device still echo in your head when you go to sleep at night?
No, they don't say that. It's
device Russian, but you know the sentiment remains the same.
Oh yeah. It's like tada, you know, that's what they always saying. You know, it's like let's go. Okay, Doom.
Oh dear, he's turning around, oh my goodness, he just gets torn apart. Doom delight for dessert as they look forward for the Tiny as well. They've got the coil out onto him. This might make it kill number two. He did manage to get a cheeky kill onto Kaz, but he's most certainly going to lose his life. But that XHD gets a double. Oh, dear me. Yeah, very, very sloppy. Just we're praising RR for being a good captain. I mean, that was a part where he's like, okay, guys, we're going to go bottom. We're going to go push it in. Then Doom just dies. And he's like, what the? I just told you
guys.
I'm
just going to say RR is on the right side of the map, right? He knows like where he should be. And now he's setting up for top. That means this must be a good play right here. Raging Potato, he wants to ulti this. Inkswell is on the ready.
Oh, could be
They're
cheeky.
Go in together.
Could be cheeky.
Oh, no. Terrible knows something fishy is going on.
He doesn't trust anyone. He knows that there could be something at work here. So he's just gonna let the tower fall to his illusions instead. Nice and safe. And yeah, then inevitably Raging Potato comes popping out of the woodwork. There's always that spot of, you know, sometimes you're pushing a lane and your brain's going, I shouldn't be here. I'm about to get jumped. And then sometimes you listen to that, you get back, and then you just watch the creep wave die to like a combo which would have killed you, and you're like, oh man, I'm so smart, I'm so good. But then other times you just ignore it, and then you die, and you're like, Why did I let that happen? Like, I knew exactly what was going on here. Meanwhile, they're actually jumping the Sand King here, trying to stop him from taking this outpost, but XHD coming into this one as well. Grimstroke does get himself with an ultimate, but there's not really much follow-up as Grimstroke does get hit by the Boundless Strike. Raging Potato is going to lose his life here, but in comes Paolo's going for the Quick Strike, going for a kill, but this Grimstroke ult is actually going to miss. Somehow gets off that long-range Omni Slash onto XHD, but with the Wukongs, it gives him the armor to survive through the Omni, and now with the coil down, the Juggernaut's in trouble. Doom does come down onto the puck in the backline. Jug still fighting and will take down XHD, and Kaz in some trouble as well. He gets quick slashed up and taken on down. In comes the Urspirit as well to jump the Juggernaut. They will be able to get that return kill, but Urspirit does die for his sins. Safe health now just fighting up into Ken. Reggie Potato goes for the buyback. Meanwhile, Safe Health still in a little bit of trouble here. He doesn't have his BKB up, and now DZ's coming on forwards. He's got the Avatos combination, four star Finn. Avatos out. Damage is there. He needs to find a Sun. The target does get off onto the Tiny. Meanwhile, though, Raging Potato, he's cooking up a big storm. And inside of the epicenter, Terrorblade will fall, inevitably. And that is going to be a full five-man wipe for the side of Blaze. They lose their Juggernaut on the side of Execration, but totally worth it. What were the main key factors on Execration being able to take this fight?
Well, the first thing was the Omni Slash onto the Monkey King. I thought he was doing a really good job at, you know, using Wukong's, getting that armor up, trying to fight him back. But then the Doom came in, doomed up the Puck, and then they go in and kill the Monkey first, and he gets that Quick Slash again. It's just such good execution of the Juggernaut skills there. Terrorblade coming in super late. He doesn't have meta. They kill the Jug, but then after that, all your team is already dead, right? You know, this Doom has an AC. He does so much damage, especially if he's with the Doom, with the Jug here. And if the Terrorblade is all alone, like we saw last fight, he's just gonna die, right?
Yeah.
Execution's game plan should always be kill everybody else, let the Terrorblade there. He's gonna do a little bit of damage, but it doesn't even matter. After that, he's going to die after his BKB's off cooldown anyway.
Earth Spirit turns into Lava Spirit as he's melted down in the middle lane. Do you know the difference between lava and magma?
I want to say yes, but I don't.
Lava is on top of the earth, and magma is inside the earth. So a volcano shoots out lava, but before it comes out of the volcano, it's actually magma. Oh, I always thought that was interesting.
Yeah, that shit scares the shit out of me. Okay, like,
is that one of those irrational fears? What? It's like when you're a kid and you're always terrified of quicksand, and then you're an adult and you realize. Smoke. Quicksand doesn't matter to your day-to-day life. Let's see Raging Potato jump in on the mid, but they actually go on the backlines here. They found themselves both the Grimstroke and the Doom, but can they get the follow-up damage? XHD with the Wukongs, and this Aghanim's Coil doing so much work. Down go two heroes straight off the bat, and Execration make their mark on this game, and they're looking forward towards a Tiny as well. Can they run him down? Meanwhile, the Juggernaut, he's playing around in the backlines and actually going for the Omni Slash. Meanwhile, they will be able to get the kill onto XHD on the back as he tried to go forward onto a target without his team. The lack of communication from Blaze. This could get messy. They're going for the Juggernaut. There's heroes coming in from behind them, though, but the BKB being popped from the Terrorblade. He's got eyes on the back of his head, and he will be able to chop down that Jug. BDZ unable to get the initiation. Meanwhile, this Urspirit is going to roll on forwards to control up the Tiny. Safe health turns around for the creeps, and that's going to mean that Dot Dot kind of dies instead. Slightly questionable from the Terrorblade there, but nevertheless.
Oh, it was a Ghost Scepter. I think the Tiny was still a Ghost Scepter.
Ah, I see. Sorry.
Yeah. No problem. Interesting fight. They get that nice pickoff onto the Grimstroke first.
Yep.
And that, he did not cast a single spell, and then he just died from it. I think somebody even force staffed him. Or is there a force staff? No, there wasn't. Okay. I saw the coil snap. And then, but yeah, the Grim dying at the start of the fight and the Doom, it just made it so one sided. They're up 20k gold, but they're not playing like it.
No.
Because they're constantly split up on the map. And on the side of Blaze, they just. They're just like five-manning, they're smoking up, they're going together every time the meta's up, and just like that, they're actually making their way back into this game, which is so weird considering the advantage Execration has right now in terms of items.
Yeah, if you want a textbook example on how not to play into Terrorblade, I think we're getting one right now, but hopefully, I mean, they're taking some good fights and they're taking some awful fights. Raging Potato getting caught out, pushing in this top lane here. It looks like, oh, the blink just in time, actually dodging out every single one of the Jakira spells. They're even forced to pop the coil for it as well, but they will be able to kill off the Sand King and have themselves a nice roasted scorpion. Delicacy out here. Finally.
You want to say crab finally, again?
Yeah, finally the Sand King dies and finally Nomad gets the analogy right.
Literally the Scorpion King.
Yeah.
Call them a crab.
I call everything a crab, though. I mean, you've... My Farad, I've casted like over 100 games, and he realizes that I just seem to call everything a crab for some reason. Nick Sesson, crab. Sand King, crab. I think it's just my frustration that there's no crab hero in Dota. Like, I'd love a crab hero which could only walk sideways. That'd be amazing. with like no turn rate if he goes side to side. Oh, the dream. Meanwhile, looking onto the Terrorblade here, he just immediately BKBs. What is that? I mean, I guess he's just gonna get jumped by the Tiny, yeah.
He didn't want to get like stun comboed by Tiny and Doomed or something like that, I guess. Oh god, another BKB used by Monkey now. Going for the bounty rune. He actually got the bounty at least.
Ooh, I see a spoiler. Goodbye. 10-day timeout. See you later, buddy. See you after the event. Anyways. Thanks, Creation. Holding this high ground. I mean, both teams just really looking into Roche right now. They know how important it is. Setting up the vision for it. Trying to get themselves positioned correctly for it. And again, you know, this isn't the moves of a team which is 16k ahead. You know, a team which is 16k ahead, you'd expect them just to be invading and immediately looking to put down the pressure and secure this Roche themselves just by forcing Blaze off the map. But they can't do that anymore because this Terrorblade is really, really strong. And he is such a strong carry hero. And they are scared. And now they make the jump here. They're going onto the Doom again, kind of caught out. He's got the BKB though. If the Grimstroke is here, they can maybe go for something, but he is not turning up to this one. The Doom's going to go down for 90 seconds without buyback. I mean, one of the back lines, this Grimstroke could be in some trouble. The Air Spirit's gone in really deep for this one. And now Safe Health going to back him up. And that means they can't stick around for the kill. Excretion need to leave, but look at Beyond. He's setting up. He wants the Jug Science there as well. Roll forwards in from the Air Spirit, but it's a little bit clumsy from the side of Blaze. And Air Spirit needs to leave. The Quick Slash is just going to get him. That is a broken ass ability, but it does get the kill.
What is Earth Spirit doing? Why did he go in there? He's done such a good job at like baiting them out, and then he really tried to go in for that. They could have just went back and did Roshan if Earth Spirit didn't die there, I think. But now this was like a really bad Rosh attempt.
Yeah,
this is like a really bad rush.
Oh no, and they go on the jump lines, immediately getting down the back. Here is the Puck and the Monkey King just get chopped up for dinner. And now, meanwhile, I was going to die to the Terrorblade. He still has a lot of damage to offer, but with BDZ on the back lines, they just cannot risk this fight. They need to run themselves away. And again, BKB and Meta are on cooldown, so there really doesn't seem like there's many ways for Blaze to take this next fight. But at the same time, they don't want to give it up. They can't give it up. They need to find a way to fight this one as the Coil comes in the back here, going for the Juggernaut this time around. Do they have the damage? Do they have the follow-up? He gets on the Master, he gets off the Omni Slash as well. I know it's Quick Slash actually, as the Omni Slash was used before, so he is still in trouble here. They're trying to run it down, but Raging Potato with the three-man Burrow Strike is just enough to keep the Juggernaut okay. Beyond's still chasing in for this one, but the Healing Ward's healing him up. Yeah, Beyond's not that safe here. Meanwhile, in comes Raging Potato once again, looking for the plate, and he's making it happen. Oh my goodness, the three-man stun into the kill onto the Puck. He's sent to the grave for 110 seconds without buyback. Hello, Roshan. This one is most certainly going the way of the Juggernaut. Absolutely.
Okay, Ken. Just don't get picked off. We're going to get this Aegis.
Don't dive tier 4s, buddy.
Just chill. Not even tier 4. He's got picked like every time but a Coil. But Coil Puck is dead this time around. So at least we know he won't die here. They're going to get the Aegis on the Juggernaut, the cheese. This is going to be the high ground play now. So that last fight, the TB had about 7 seconds left on meta when they went into the pit. That was a very bad call to go into the pit.
Yeah.
Like, with 7 seconds left on your meta. You can't be making that call like that. You have to kill more than just one Doom. You don't even know if that Doom has buyback, right? If he has buyback and you're low health, you come back, you're gonna die. It's terrible. And Monkey, Puck both have to buyback because they got surprised on. Now the Puck's dead for 100 seconds. Next time Monkey dies, he's also dead for 130 seconds. And that could just be the GG if he dies again. So he needs to make sure he is not joining these fights until the very, very end.
How come the Jug doesn't Manta off the Reflection? Is he just saving it for silences or something?
Some bigger spells? Yeah, probably.
Okay.
I mean, he doesn't really care if he takes a little bit of damage. He's got that healing. Oh!
No, he doesn't. Quick slash it up.
He doesn't have MKB. These illusions are quite annoying. They also have some evasion on them, and they're pretty tanky too.
Yep, with that level 10 taunt, in case you guys at home don't know, it's always going to be a factor with a TB game, is that he's just got 16% evasion as standard. Why? I don't know.
Do they have solo quest on anyone? That would be a really nice item from the Juggernaut. That's like one of the best amplification item for him.
Mm-hmm.
Like one of your teammates got to put that on him. He just quick slashing creeps.
Yeah,
bro, that's about 100 mana, man.
Why not, I guess? Why not? Now they're finding these tier 4 items. Yep, Timeless Relic. Setting back, what are the Juggernaut want here? Just the leveler for the pure attack speed?
Oh, that would be nice, actually. Leveler or the cape, Illusionist cape, would be very nice, too.
Yeah, always good, always good.
Yeah, you can cut an entire creep wave with Juggernaut's Illusion Escape. It's very strong, high stats.
Smoke up from Blaze.
Oh, here comes the
something. And in they go, they found the Doom! How many times can they find him? Four stuff away though, gonna get him to relative safety, stunned for a long time. They don't seem to have the follow-up damage. Yes, they do. Never mind, the TB is in the house, and he is taking names right now. Paolo's back himself away. The Doom is back, yeah. Meanwhile, Spirit rolling over the side here, trying to find a pickle, but might have just put himself in a bit of a pickle as he's gonna get killed off, and now the aggression comes turning in the other way here. They're looking for kills. Beyond is out. Meanwhile, Jakiro, maybe not quite so lucky as Ken is exactly his revenge, and they're gonna get him with a quick slash. Paolo's gets BDZ. A double. Oh no! Beyond, he gets caught out by BDZ. The Ethereal Blade, Veil, Discord, Avatos combo is enough to bring down the puck. Jesus.
That's exactly. It was actually 100-0 on the puck there. He had orb and he had phase shift, but then he didn't think he was gonna die. He actually got cursed by that.
1,620 damage done by Avalanche. Are you kidding
timeless
me?
Relic.
That's like everything. He's going over to the TB now as well. He's going to get the TB. TB has no buyback. BDZ is just soloing the goddamn game. They're going to GG out. What the hell, man? What are you doing, Tiny? Who needs a carry when you've got BDZ? Oh my goodness. What the ending?
Just suddenly like that.
What the